And what I want to encourage you is in the days and the weeks and the months to come, that if the family comes to mind, that you might give a call, or you might drop a card or an email or something like that, to continue to support them and to be there for them. Let them know that you have not forgotten them. And so what I've learned is that we don't know how long our lives will be. And for James, he was 10 days short of his 17th birthday, and I don't know how many realize this Wednesday will be his 17th birthday. So you can be praying for mom and dad and the family. God is big enough and loving enough to understand what we are going through, even if we get angry with him. But you do need to find proper outlet to deal with your grief. Time is the greatest healer, but it's also good to find someone to talk to. A trusted teacher, a school counselor, a local pastor or youth pastor, your parents, a good friend, or God. The worst thing you can do is bottle it up and try to tackle it yourself, because that can lead to depression. I personally like to do something physical, like playing basketball or going for a run, whatever works best for you. Also, in dealing with James's death, don't look at the what coulda, shoulda been's. Be thankful that you've had James in your life and the wonderful memories that you have. Share them with friends and family. James has died, but his memory shouldn't. From day one, you were surrounded by family who loved you unconditionally. You were an active child, a talented kid who had a lot of natural athletic ability. Sports seemed to come easy to you. You were good at them, and we loved watching you. You idolized your brother, loved being around him, hanging on him, pestering him. You were a tough kid with a kind heart who got along easily with kids both older and younger. You had a great sense of humor from early on. I remember Mr. Overstreet, your fourth and fifth grade teacher, at every conference would go on and on about what a great sense of humor you had, especially for your age. He was so amazed. I remember our camping trips, how you and Austin loved going down the rapids, which were only about 6 inches deep. They gave me scars on my shins, but I would keep doing it because it made you guys happy. I love you so much, James. This isn't the way it's supposed to be. You're only 16. Your life is just beginning. There is so much you haven't experienced. I miss you so much. I will miss going to your games. I will miss our family TV nights. You laying with your legs stretched out across my lap, just waiting for the opportunity to see how close to my face you could get with your dirty sock before I noticed. I will no longer hear your voice saying, "Mom, light, you always watch TV in the dark." You will no longer be waiting for me to walk into the kitchen so you could ask to get you a pickle or a drink because you didn't want to put your game on hold. I miss your sense of humor and the way you tease me. I will miss your beautiful blue eyes, your incredible smile, the faces you made, and how you would wrinkle your forehead. I will miss seeing you turn 17, graduate from high school, go to college, get a place of your own, get married, and have children. I love you so much. And I am so thankful to have been able to spend these last years at home with you. I enjoy driving you and your friends to school every morning before you got your car, watching your interactions, all laughing and joking around, wondering what the topic of the day will be. So much info in such a short distance, sometimes too much information. You made this world a better place, and it will be such a sadder world without you. Thank you, James, for giving me so many great memories to hold on to you. I love you.